Hey, Shalom, Israel. Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises to Yahweh, Baha Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Baha Hashem, Rekak Wadash. I want to give double honors to the Elders and Apostles of Great Millstone for bringing out 100% truth and keeping it real. Salutations to the 144 hopeful elect of Israel who's pushing this word in all truth and sincerity, and the 1/3 of Israel who believe in the word and follow the Lamb wherever we go. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shalom. Yeah, we're going to bring this epistle out through the Spirit and the power of Yahweh Shem Hashah. It took a turn, bro. It was going to be entitled, it probably will still be, I'm not sure. I wanted to entitle it something like, Feel Better Already, you know. Be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only. Because right before the Passover, I had an epistle speaking about how we were looking forward to the Passover. Looking forward to the purge of the old leaven, you know. You know, looking forward to this time, you know, of rest, the Sabbath day, you know, and all that, everything that goes along with it, you know, coming closer and closer to Yahweh Shem Hashah, coming back to our heritage, and you know, performing these works, being doers of the word, because you know, everything that the Lord has given us, these commandments, these laws, are for our good, right? So this epistle is based around that purged out the old leaven, and I want to go get a few words in the I did it last night. I should have did the epistle last night, but you know, man's goings of the Lord. I wanted to get a few definitions from the precept, you know, and that's what this epistle is based around, right? But as I began to get this epistle together, you know, the general heaviness came upon me, you know, about, you know, the times we're living in, and that we're yet this day in our captivity. And there's a brother, he's got an epistle coming out right now. It's like a premiere coming up in like 2 minutes. It's for the most part, and that's the spirit, man. He said, for the most part, things will not go your way. Keep the faith. You know, I see it right there, man. And Lord willing, I'll be able to put it in the description box. You know, for the most part, things will not go your way. Keep the faith, right? Just like we were speaking about. Like the title of this epistle, once again, Feel Better Already. You know, be ye doers of the word. Because, you know, you get a certain amount of, it's a constant fight, bro, in this sinful flesh. We're in the hands of our enemies. Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race, the devil the Bible speaks of. Turn everything upside down. Still got to go to the plantation. You know, so many different struggles and fights, because Yahweh Shem Hashah is a God of war. But at the end, you know, the Lord speaks about us having an everlasting kingdom, being joint heirs in the kingdom of heaven with Yahweh Shah, being on top, bro. That rest. But for now, we must fight. We got to keep the faith. And we're just going to get into this epistle. Lord willing, it's going to come out okay, you know. Lord willing, you guys, you know, you, through the spirit and power, Yahweh Shem Hashah, be edified and exhorted. Just you know, just really talking about exactly what the title said: be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. Because there's a lot of Israelites that really don't know what they're involved in, bro. You know, think it's like a joke or some kind of game or something, but it's a fight, man. We're fighting for. We're trying to be the ruling class government, man, in the kingdom of heaven forever and ever, bro. This ain't no little small matter, bro. We're talking about, you know, we it's a race. We're fighting, bro. And it's all through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shem Hashah. It's all predestinated. But once again, we're in this carnal flesh. And we are the Lord's instruments. We're his spirits, you know. So we're just doing what the Lord has commanded us to do. So let's get into the epistle. Once again, Lord willing, it's going to be edifying and exhorting, bro. Oh, Lord, here come that nose. I want to go back to that Deuteronomy. Where are my glasses at? Go back to this Deuteronomy real quick. 4:4. Like we were speaking about the other night at live camp, you know. These words are for the children of Israel, the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indians. This is the Bible, the word of the Lord, is for us, bro. This is our heritage. This is who we are. The Lord has chosen us to be his special people, man. But ye that did cleave unto the Lord your God are alive, every one of you this day. Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments, even as the Lord my God commanded me, that ye should do so in the land whether you go to possess it. Keep therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nation, which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people. For what nation is there so great, who have Yahweh Shemashah so nigh unto them, as the Lord our God is in all things that we call upon him for? And what nation is there so great, who have statutes and judgments so righteous as all this law which I set before you this day? Only take heed to thyself and keep thy soul diligently, lest thou forget the things which thou eyes have seen, and lest they depart from thine heart all the days of thy life. But teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons. Right, and which brings us right back to this time, you know, of the Passover. These wonderful laws that the Lord's got us, you know, got us. He's got certain things set up for us to, just man fall down seven times, but he get back up. He got certain things set in place, understanding the battles that we're going to go through, that we're able to catch ourselves, you know. And we're going to get, when we go to that, Corinthians, we're going to see it real quick. Let's continue on, man. I want to go get this Joshua real quick. Just to set it up, how wonderful actually the laws are for us. You know, the law is good, you know, and all these precepts, these laws of life, you know, was it what we were talking about the other night? Basic instruction before leaving earth. This is the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then shalt thou have good success. And y'all gonna see, you know, as we go along in this epistle, what I'm trying to convey through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shemashah. Not using my own words, but the words of the Lord, you know. This is the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5. Examine yourselves, whether you be in the faith. Prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves? How that Yahweh Shah is in you, except ye be reprobates, bro. Once again, going back to what we just read. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 4. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. Are we doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving our own selves? All these wonderful laws that the Lord has given us, these laws of life, to make our time here prosperous and better, you know, to keep our spirit, you know, intact, a level head, not to be carnal, not to be a part of this wicked world, you know. And we're going to get a scripture talking about some not being overcharged with surfeiting. All these things, you know, and it's a lot to take in, and it's a lot, you know. Sometimes you might get overwhelmed, or sometimes you might be overtaken. You know, once again, just man fall down seven times, but get back up. So we constantly are going through these things. We're constantly going off. We're constantly getting back up. We're constantly praying to Yahweh Shemashah. We're constantly coming to the Lord, repenting. We're constantly examining ourselves. Examine yourself, whether you be in the faith. Prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves, how that Yahweh Shah is in you, except ye be reprobates. Right, except ye be reprobates, bro. Except you be like, no, I'm good. No, hey, despite all the rebukes, you know, despite you're rebuking your own self, but you refuse to change. You refuse to come back to Yahweh Shemashah. So we got to examine ourselves, man. This is the book of Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 18, verse 20. Before judgment, examine thyself, and in the day of visitation, thou shalt find mercy. Okay? That's what we're talking about, see, because constantly speaking about and thinking about the overall general picture of the times we're living in, understanding and believing in this word. Yes, Lord, we heard thy report and we was afraid, you know. And coming to Yahweh Shemashah, asking the Lord for mercy, and you know, to the best of our abilities, being doers of the word and not hearers only, applying these words, these beautiful words that the Lord has blessed us with, man, in this day. This is the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 16. This I say then, walk in the spirit. Sometimes it's easier said than done, right? But hey, we got to continue to fight. This I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary the one to the other. So that, this is the point we want to make, so that you cannot do the things that ye would. Right, if you run around and you're carnal, but if you be led by the spirit, you're not under the law. Okay? Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, illuminations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in times past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of Yahweh Shem HaShai. Right, and the five wise versions are preparing their hearts and minds for the return of the Lord. You know, being conformed to the image of the Son, constantly, you know, going that gold tried in the fire, constantly examining themselves, you know. Okay, being plugged into the 100% truth. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that you would, bro. It's very important, and that's once again, bro. Once again, bro, that's why I was speaking the other day, like, man, I'm so thankful, I'm so glad, you know, for this truth, number one. So thankful for this time of the Passover coming up. You know, to get, you know, to the Lord has blessed us with this time to, you know, examine, to purge out that leaven, you know, cause hey, it ain't easy, man. Sometimes you might be going off and you'll be like trying to, hey man, I gotta get right, you know, and then it's just not easy, bro. Through the Spirit and the power of Yahweh Shem HaShai, and all, you know, what the scriptures say, thou confess thy sins, you know, Yahweh Shem HaShai is not unrighteous to forgive, you know. And it says, confess thy sins before, you know, before the brothers and stuff, man. What did the Lord say? Only acknowledge thine offense, brothers. We know we're just some filthy rags. We know we're just some filthy rags. And we do need Yahweh Shem HaShai. This is the book of Luke chapter 21, verse 34. And take heed unto thyself, lest at any time your heart be overcharged with surfeiting. Okay, can we look up this word? Let's see, look up surfeiting. Look up now shows personalized suggestions from the web. Okay, it says surfeiting, an excess amount of something, you know, excess. It says overeating occurs when an individual consumes more calories, you know, so they got different. You know, they're talking about overeating here. So it's all about over, you know, it's talking about overindulging in things. That's why the Lord said, hey, how do you get rid of it? Gotta get rid of it, bro. Y'all see, I'm trying to get rid of it. Oh, Lord, come on, man. Don't do this. Boy, don't mess with me. Let me see. It's all that. Damn computer. That's okay. It's lucky, bro. I just didn't want to mess up the recording because it's not easy sometimes, bro. Damn demons. So, and take heed unto thyself, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting, overindulgent in the, you know, being wrapped up in the cares of the affairs of this world, you know, or being carnal, or, you know, doing too much of this or that. And drunkenness. Do I dare touch it again? Let's even look up this one. Look, the phone going off. It's tripping. It's tripping. Y'all see that? It's tripping. Come on, let's just move on, man. And take heed to thyself, lest at any time your heart be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that day come upon you unawares. Okay? For as a snare, it shall come on all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Okay? Watch therefore and pray always that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. Right, man, we got to be watching. You know, we're not in darkness. This is not some kind of joke or some kind of game, okay? So this is a powerful scripture right here, you know? And take heed unto thyself. And this is all about being doers of the word, not hearers only. Examine yourself, whether you be in the faith. Prove your own self, bro, okay? Take heed to thyself. We're fighting for our lives over here. We're coming to Yahweh Shem HaShai for mercy, to have mercy on us. And we understand it's all predestinated. You know, the 144 hopefully elect and 1/3 of Israel are covered. But are we those men? So we're putting on as the elect, bro. And take heed to thyself, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that day come upon you unawares. No, yeah, we got to be diligent, bro. This is the book of 2 Peter, 2 Peter, chapter 1, verse 10. Wait, let's jump up a little bit. Let's start at verse 4. Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises. There's a lot of Israelites that don't really see this. They don't understand this. They don't get this. This wasn't given, you know, like the scripture said, it was given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. To them, it wasn't given. They don't even know, you know, that there's a war going on right here, a spiritual battle. That we're putting our best foot forward to please Yahweh Shemashiah in this time. The Lord has blessed us to understand his name. You know, he's blessed us, you know, to believe in his word, to get this gift of faith, bro. So whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped, look, bro, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust, you know? And that's why you got to hold on to these things. That's what we're talking about over here, being purged. Get that shit out of there. And beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge. Let's look up this word virtue, see if we're going to do it this time. Come on, bro. You see this, bro? It's fucking with me. Okay, that's just demons, bro. And to knowledge, temperance, and to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Yahweh Shai. Right, because what does scripture say? Wisdom will flee deceit. We got to go get it. It says, but he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off. Right. We want to stay, keep that eye single on the things that are at hand. Keep the eye single on the promises. Keep the eye single. You know, 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 11, seeing that all these things shall be dissolved. What manner of person ought you to be in all conversation and holiness? Roughly paraphrasing, you know. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off and have forgotten that he was purged, bro. Purged. That we're talking about. From his old sins, my man. Don't go back. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence. Give diligence, bro, to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, ye shall never fail. See, there's an order that the Lord has set up. You know, starting with the elders, apostles, great millstone, and all the brothers on that umbrella, man. You know, comforting each other with these words. Constantly edifying and exhorting brothers to continue in the faith. Like I just spoke about this brother over here. Let me see if I can find that post real quick. I don't know if I can do it. I don't know if it's going to come up on this. I tried to click on it and, you know, try to put it in the history. I don't think it's going to come up. Let me see something. No, it's not going to come up, bro. I'll just see if I can put it in the description box later on. Let's go back to 1 Corinthians. But yeah, once again, I just want to make mention of the title of that epistle that we're talking about. It says, For the most part, things will not go your way. Keep the faith, bro. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Yeah, and I was thinking about, you know, got to go to the plantation. Oh, look, this is what we're talking about here. Purge out the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump, as ye are unleavened, for even Yahweh Shai, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Okay, sincerity and truth. Sincerity and truth. Being doers of the word, not hearers only. You know, being well-rounded and well-rooted and grounded in the faith of truth. understanding the time that is at hand, about the MERK coming up, the implementation of the MERK, all these plagues that's coming on Babylon the Great, aka America, and around the world, and how Yahweh Shemashah say, you know, be not afraid, neither doubt, I'll be your guide. He's gonna help us. This is a trying of our faith, you know. So we want to stay diligent to make our calling and election sure. We want to stay right there, man. Not turning to the left, not turning to the right, just constantly enduring, okay? Just constantly enduring, bro. And so thankful once again. I want to get this in the blue letter too, man, okay? So thankful once again, bro, for this time. Let's see. Copy. Blue letter. Okay, look, here it is. See, I told you something was wrong with that thing. Five and seven. I'm gonna get it in the KJV. Dismiss. Okay, and then we're gonna get these words here. Purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump. I want to get that word leaven. Purge therefore the old leaven here. And what does it say? Ferment as of boiling up leaven. Show outline biblical use leaven. And it says of invertebrate mental and moral corruption, bro. Corruption. Okay, viewed in its tendency to infect others. We don't want to be corrupted, you know. We don't want to be corrupted. It says leaven is applied to the to that substance which is small in quantity yet thoroughly pervades a thing by its influence. The NT uses it in both a positive or negative sense. A little leaven leavened up the whole lump, bro. Okay? So, mental and moral corruption, bro. And it reminds me of that scripture we just read, you know, that you would not do the things that you would, you know, walk in the spirit, you know. Walk in the spirit, my man. And that's what we're talking about with this epistle here. So it says, once again, purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump. Ye are unleavened, for even Yahushua, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. And I want to go here to get a couple of words in this one in verse 8. Therefore, let us keep the feast not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness. I want to get this wickedness right here. Wickedness. Malice, plural. Plots, sins, iniquity, which is sin upon sin, bro. Depravity, iniquity, sin upon sin, wickedness, evil purposes, and desires, bro. So, you know, don't let your heart be overcharged with surfeiting. I want to bring that point out, man. So once again, not with old leaven, neither with leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Of sincerity and truth. Hold on. I want to get. Okay, we want to go back to 1 Corinthians. Lord willing, brothers and sisters, this is making sense. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 27. Let's start at 24. Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run, that ye may obtain, bro. And every man that striveth for the masteries is temperate in all things. Now, they do it to obtain a corruptible crown. Right? Hey, but we, an incorruptible. This is very precious, man. Therefore, so run. Right? We're talking about the kingdom of heaven. An everlasting rulership. This arise ye in the part, for this is not our rest. This is not our time to be trying to get it or you know, indulging in, overindulge in certain pleasures and stuff, man. You know, the Lord has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light to do a job. He called us to be conformed to the image of his son. He called us, you know, for his name's sake, brothers and sisters. So we're fighting for these things, fighting for Yahweh Shemashai, to be obedient to his word to the best of our abilities in this carnal flesh. Okay? And, you know, all praise to Yahweh Shemashai for all the safeguards that he's given us. You know, all the blessings that he's bestowed on us. All the chastisements that he keeps, you know, on us. You know, what, you know, like the scriptures say, you know, Lord, he chastening who he loves. But if you're without chastening, you're a bastard and not a son. So going back to this 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24, and every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run. Not as uncertainly. No, man, because we believe Yahweh Shemashiach has blessed us with this gift of faith. Right now, at this very moment, bro, he's letting it be known that these other Israelite camps and groups are clearly going off. You know, and they don't have the spirit of Yahweh Shemashiach. They don't have the spirit of prophecy. They don't even know what the M-A-R-K is. I think it's this. I think it's that. They're going off. And the Lord has blessed us to see these things. You know? So I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I. Not as one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, okay? Just man falleth down 7 times, but what? He gets back up through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Shemashai. You know, through the encouraging words of the brothers and their exhorting epistles. You know, comforting each other with these words. Like the brother just said up there, keep the faith. You know? But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, bro, I myself should be a castaway. You know, because you got to strive lawfully. You can't be no demon out here doing us thou wilt. No. Yahweh Shemashiach has given us straight commandments what we should do to avoid punishment, bro. We don't know if we're covered by the blood of the Lamb. We don't know if we're 144 hopeful elect and one. We don't know if we're 144 elect. Let's go to the book of Revelation chapter 21, verse 7. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving and abominable, you know, doing things that the Lord hate, and murderers, and whoremongers, and sorcerers, and idolaters, you know. You love yourself more than the Lord, bro. And liars, and all liars, handling the word deceitfully, no. Shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. We're trying to avoid the second death, okay. Coming to Yahweh Shemashai for mercy. Coming to the Lord for strength. We're going to go to the book of John chapter 15, verse 1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. I hope y'all can hear this song in the background. I want to run to you. We constantly run into you. How about Shemashai? Lord, please forgive me. I done messed up over here. Lord, please give me strength. Please put the spirit on me to bring out this epistle. Please let me do your will, Yahweh Shemashai. Please don't let me fall. Please don't take that Holy Spirit away from me. You know? I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Okay, we clean, being washed and clean and baptized with this word of truth. That's why, you know, all praise to you, Yahweh Shemashiach, for putting the spirit on the elder apostle Tahar. But to say, hey man, you know, if you can make an epistle every day, or at least 3 times a week, bro, to edify. You know, the Lord said, if you love me, feed my sheep. Also to keep yourself, you know, from the snares, from the wiles and the cares affairs of this life. You know, being dedicated, making yourself a living sacrifice to the word of Yahweh Shemashiach. You know, being a faithful doer and not just a hearer, bro. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same branch, so like the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Without Yahabashimashah, you can do nothing, bro. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. That's why you got to, man, hold on to Yahabashimashah, bro. Don't turn to the left. Don't turn to the right. This is a very, very serious thing. And that's why I was saying, the other day, man, I was looking so forward to this time of the Passover, the time, you know, mandatory to purge out that old leaven, you know, just like the Day of Atonement, where it's mandatory that you go on a fast. Sometimes we need that discipline, bro. Not trying to be over righteous, just knowing that just a filthy rag in this carnal flesh is not easy, my man, brothers and sisters. But fight I, not as one that beateth the air. You know what I'm talking about? This is the book of James, chapter 1, verse 22. But be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any be a hearer of the word, and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself, and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was, bro. What manner of man he was. But whosoever looketh into the perfect law of liberty, you know, don't use your liberty as a cloak of maliciousness, you see? And continue therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deeds, bro. I love it, bro. We're going to start to go ahead and wrap it up. Now, going back to what we were speaking about earlier. You know, the heaviness still yet this day in our captivity. You know, Yahabashimashah is gonna come with healing in his wings, bro. He's gonna change our vile bodies. You know, give us those immortal bodies and put the laws in our inward parts. Just hold on. Keep the faith, like the brother say. I will bear the indignation of the Lord, Yahabashimashah, because I have sinned against him. Until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me, he will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold his righteousness. I think that brother should be that epistle should be up by now. Let me go see if it's on. It's not coming up on my phone for some reason. Hold on, let me go turn it on the computer. Oh shoot, it said it's going to be premiered in two hours from now. So look, we just have to hold on, bro. This is the book of Micah, chapter 7, verse 9. I was just reading in Daniel chapter 9. If y'all got to get a minute to go read it, read that Daniel chapter 9, verse 7. You know, because, you know, we sinned against Yahabashimashah, but he's showing us mercy for his name's sake right now. So we're coming back to Yahabashimashah with weeping, with mourning, with supplication, understanding, knowing, and believing all the things that we have done. And, you know, this is it. But the Lord is going to come and, you know, redeem us. And this is the story. And for that reason, you know, we're his spirits, man. We're his spirits, and Lord willing, we're going to endure to the end through the spirit and power of Yahabashimashah. Lord willing, we're those vessels of honor, you know. I will bear the indignation. So we're putting on as the elect, bro. We're being diligent to make our calling and election sure. We're believing in the word to the best of our abilities wholeheartedly, okay? I will bear the indignation of Yahabashimashah because I have sinned against him until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me. He will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold his righteousness. Okay? And all these people that don't believe in Yahweh Shemashah that's going off. All these Eves out here as well, you know. The children of Israel, the bride, the wife, you know. Jerusalem is like a delicate and comely woman. Then she that is my enemy, the two-thirds, you know, and Eve. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which shall say to me, where is the Lord thy God? Mine eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire in the streets, bro. Okay, because, you know, that reminds me of that scripture in the book of, is it Isaiah chapter 65? Let's see. 65 verse 5. Or is it 55? Isaiah 55 verse 6. No. Shoot, which one is it? Is it, then they should be ashamed. Hold on, let me go see if I can find it real quick. Your brothers that hate you. Come on, baby, come on. Okay. Yeah, it says Isaiah chapter 66, verse 5. That's where it was. We were so close. Hear the word of the Lord, Yahweh Shemashah, ye that tremble at his word. Your brethren that hated you, that cast you out for my name's sake, said, let the Lord be glorified, but he shall appear to your joy, and they shall be ashamed, bro. Yeah, we wholeheartedly believe in this word of truth. We're not trying to be a part of this world. We're trying to be, to the best of our abilities, obedient to the word of Yahweh Shemashah. This is the book of Luke chapter 17, verse 7. You know, but which of you... Let's start at verse 6. And the Lord said, if ye have faith as grain of mustard seed, ye might say unto this sycamore tree, be thou plucked up by the root, and be thou planted in the sea, and it shall obey you. But which of you, having a servant plowing or feeding cattle, will say unto him by and by, when he is come from the field, go sit down and to meat, and will not rather say unto him, make ready wherewith I may sup, and gird thyself and serve me till I have eaten and drinken, and afterwards thou shalt eat and drink? Doth he thank that servant because he did the things that were commanded him? I trow not. So likewise ye, when ye shall have done all those things which are commanded of you, say, we are unprofitable servants, we have done that which is was our duty, man, to do so. Yeah, so the promises, you know, Yahweh Shemashah declared to us. You know, we gotta go through these things right now. You know, he's told us about these spiritual powers, and we believe it, bro. He's spoken about, you know, when the enemy shall come in like a flood, he's gonna lift up a standard. We believe it though. He said, I'm going to give my angels charge over you. We believe it, bro. You know, in this time of Jacob's trouble, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. We believe it, bro. So we're doing the things that are commanded of us now. So likewise, ye, when ye shall have done all those things which ye have commanded, which are commanded of you, say, we are unprofitable servants. We have done that which is our duty to do. You know, that's what's going on right now. Through the ups and downs, through the heartaches, this is what we're supposed to be doing, man. We are the Lord's chosen people, bro. So this is the time to fight. This is time to gird up thy loins like a man. This is the time to endure. This is the time to go through that fire. You know. Let's go to the book of Ecclesiasticus and the Apocrypha real quick. Ecclesiasticus and the Apocrypha. Chapter 12. Verse 13. It's Ecclesiasticus in the Bible. Salaki, bro. 12:13. Y'all know it. Man's all is to serve Yahweh Shemashah. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear Yahweh Shemashah. Fear the Lord. Because all the, you know, the said perils that set, you know, two-thirds of the children of Israel are going to get cut off and die. The judgments of the Lord. But the Lord has blessed us to let come back and understand who he is, to get to know him. All praise to you, HaBashem HaShah, to fear him, to love him. Therefore, being doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. So let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear Yahweh HaShem HaShah and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For Yahweh HaShem HaShah shall bring every work into judgment, bro, with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. You know, purge out that leaven, bro. Get on that track of Yahweh HaShem HaShah, my man. I want to go to the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 1. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of Yahweh HaShem HaShah, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, separate, sanctified, pure, acceptable unto Yahweh HaShem HaShah, which is your reasonable service. Once again, we're supposed to be doing this. And be not conformed to this world. Don't be overcharged with surfeiting. All this witchcraft they got out here. All these trends and all this bullshit. You know, all this lust of the flesh. Purge out that leaven, brothers and sisters. Let's go. It's that time, man. This is the Passover. This is the Feast of Unleavened Bread, brothers and sisters. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh HaShem HaShah. The Lord said, I'm gonna reprove you, Esau, Edom, the Caucasian race, the devil that the Bible speaks of, and set them in order before your eyes, bro. We're being set in order. Doing the things that please Yahweh HaShem HaShah. Turn away from this wicked ass world and all the shit that they promote. You know, like Yahweh HaShah said, Simon, Simon, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren, bro. We're going to the book of Revelation, chapter 20. Chapter 2, verse 26. And this is the next to the last scripture we're going to get. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works until the end, to him will I give power over the nations. Okay? The promise is right here, bro. Hold on. Let's jump up to 25. But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come, bro. Hold on. What the brother said, keep the faith. He that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations, and he shall rule them with the rod of iron, as the vessels of the potters. As the vessel of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I receive of my Father, and I will give him the morning star. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the churches. And we're going to close out with the second Esdras in here. Chapter 7, verse 58. You know, because we're talking about that city that's full of all good things. We're talking about the kingdom of heaven, bro. 58. That if he be overcome, he shall suffer as thou hast said. But if he get the victory, he shall receive the things that I say. For this is the life wherein Moses spoke unto the people while he lived, saying, choose thee life that thou mayest live. Nevertheless, they believed not him, nor yet the prophets after him, nor me, which have spoken unto them, that they should not be such heaviness in their destruction, as shall be joy over them that are persuaded to salvation. Okay, we're going to just leave it right there, man. This is that time to choose the life, bro. Purge out that old leaven. You know, come back. You know, this is that time, man. Yahweh HaShem HaShah has blessed us with these times. You know, to you know, be able to examine ourselves. Whether we be in the faith, to prove our own selves. You know, to make sure that we're doing things to please Yahweh HaShem HaShah. Those five wise virgins, man. Getting our mind right. Staying on track. Not be overcharged with surfeiting and the cares and affairs of this life. So, man, Lord willing, this was edifying and exhorting, brothers and sisters. I just had to bring that out through the Spirit and the power of Yahweh HaShem HaShah. You know, it was the Spirit, because I wanted to do a little short epistle. Lord willing, I'll be able to do it again, you know. But that's the Spirit, because Elder Apostle Ramlov spoke about that exact same thing, how folk at Malone, you know, trying to make sure that yo ass come back to Massa and not go to Yahweh HaShem HaShah. So we're running to Yahweh HaShem HaShah. Oh, the song, all praises to Yahweh HaShem HaShah. So with that, I want to give all honors and praises to Yahweh BaHashem, Yahweh Shah, BaHashem, Rekah Kodesh. I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles, Great Millstone, for bringing out 100% truth and keeping it real. Salutations to the 144 hopeful elect of Israel, who's pushing his word in all truth and sincerity, and the one-third of Israel who believe in the word and follow the Lamb wherever he goes. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shalom.